Thank you for watching True Vine Victor Hour, located here in New Britain, Connecticut, 477 Ella Street, where Jesus is Lord and everybody is somebody. Reverend Walter Simmons, pastor, co-pastor Evangelist Priscilla Simmons. Our order of service, Sunday school, Sunday morning, 9:30 a.m. Morning worship service, 10:30 a.m. Wednesdays, 6 p.m. prayer and Bible class combined. Program airing time is 6 o'clock p.m. every Sunday, Channel 5, Nutmeg TV. We are God creation. We are all created with a deep thirst for God in our heart, an empty longing that only God can satisfy. We try to quench that thirst with so many things: significant success, comfort, peace, wisdom. But all these things, however, is good, cannot meet our deepest need. At the root of it, we thirst for our closeness to our Creator, God Almighty. Our goal is to continue to reach the lost at any cost. Feed the hungry, clothe the naked, and visit the sick and shut in. Help our youth or tomorrow find the peace which passes all understanding and a new way of life. Feel the great commandment and great commission. What it means to be built and a disciple of Christ. Our goal is to help one to live a disciple life, to inspire, motivate, and equip every member with the right tools for making disciples of Christ in all our nations. True Vine is committed to leading the way for everyone to fulfill their calling in Christ Jesus, equipping Christians to be disciples of Christ. And if you have never invited Christ into your heart, today is the time. The Lord said, today if you hear my voice, harden not your heart. God is good, and all the time God is good. We're going to keep on moving in the name of Jesus. This is Palm Sunday, and they was, you know, Jesus coming in on the donkey, and they was waving their palms, you know. Yeah. Hosanna.
Yeah, amen.
Hosanna. You know that song? Hosanna. Stop praying. God said pray without ceasing. Pray all the time. Pray for our world leaders. Because God said, pray for the ones in authority, the kings and the leaders, that we his children. We are his children. They need a peace and quiet life and all God's life. Pray that God will save them.
Amen.
Amen. Pray for our city, the cities that where our loved ones are too, our children, grandchildren, great-grand, nieces, nephews. All our loved ones, church family.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
God hears prayer.
Yes, he does. Amen.
Now we know that God hears not a sinner. But if a man be a worship of God and does his will, him he hears. God will answer prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God is good.
All the time.
He's awesome.
Yes, he is.
He's the on time God.
Yes.
He never fails. And he won't fail us. Amen?
Amen.
All right, just trust him. And lean on it.
Yes.
And lean not to your own understanding, not my own understanding, but to what the word of God said. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right. Not one of our birthdays is in here this morning. One of my daughters.
We're talking to you.
Alright. She tired, they gonna be off. No, your birthday tomorrow.
Oh.
Oh, you and Dwayne's tomorrow. At least it's this morning.
Yes.
Alright?
Yes.
On Palm Sunday.
Yes.
Alright, let's stand and let's sing happy birthday.
Yes.
Amen. If you wanna feel special, you can sit and know it's you. Alright? All right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
You can wave your hand.
Happy birthday, dear loved one. Happy birthday to you. May the good Lord bless you.
Amen. All right. You all may be seated. Okay. And we keep on moving in the name of Jesus. And we know this week, the Lord will, that Jesus don't crack the sky and come and get all his children. It's Good Friday. Service starts at 6 o'clock. Amen. And our first word was going to be Sister White. Amen. We're going to move on in the name of Jesus. Now we're going to have a song by Brother Dickie coming up, and we're going to have our Sunday School review, and we're going to keep on moving in the name of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
All right. It don't take all day to do what we got to do for God. Amen. Amen.
Remember back, Pastor.
But you know, I was blessed when I did the song to find out that I got information from BMI that quite a few TV stations was using it for commercial purposes. So I'm saying that to say, Pastor, thank God I made my money off of this one.
Say this real quick, because Paul is saying, sometimes we make things very difficult. We find out if you want a ticket, it's a very easy ticket to get. Sometimes, you know, we want to make things so complicated because we want to look ways to go. ways the world says, I need your money. You get a ticket. God just says, all you need is to believe. That's an easy ticket to get. Don't cost you nothing. Don't cost you anything. Just cost you just saying, I believe. Pretty much what our lesson is about also. And I'm going to make this to the point as I can. Do some reading. I'm going to say something. I'm going to do something. And I'm going to sit down. But this lesson kind of brought a couple things to my mind. And I started reading a little bit with the lesson. This is just regular English. It's John, the third chapter, concerning the first prayers. It says, now there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a member of the Jewish rule council, who came to Jesus at night and said, Rabbi, we know you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can perform the miracle signs you are doing if God were not with you. And just reading that, and I was thinking last night. Last night, we went out to New York, drove to New York, and I'm thinking, drive through those streets of New York, if God wasn't with me, I wouldn't be able to do what I wanted to do. Because out there in the streets of New York, everything's out there. And as we're driving, there's a tire there, and we're on the highway. God has to be with you in order to get around all that stuff. Because it wasn't just me by myself, many other people. Now, one thing about it also, as I'm in the driver's seat, I have to look like I'm cool and collected, like I'm in control, even though I'm nervous. Because from a male perspective, we have to make sure that those around us think that we're in control, that we're cool and collected, and we can make these decisions. But we have to make that look. We have to look the part. But yet, we're nervous. And we're sweating all over the place. But one thing about the will, it's like Jesus. You gotta hold on. Because if you let go, anything can happen. It's like he said, I know who you are. And you know what? You couldn't be who you are if God wasn't with you. We couldn't be who we are if God's not with us. And it goes on, and third it says, in reply, Jesus declared, I tell you the truth. No one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again. Now, how can a man be born when he is old? And that's the typical question that we all ask, that question. Nicodemus asked, surely he cannot enter a second time into his mother's womb to be born. We just look at foot, and I'm going to stop real quick. Then Jesus answered, I tell you the truth, no man can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but Spirit gives birth to Spirit. You should not be surprised at my saying, you must be born again. Now, in thinking about that, sometimes we have to put the scripture in the way we see things. And something I've been talking about for a little while, and you've probably seen this recently, maybe a few years ago. One thing about us as adults, when our adult children truly become men and women, when we see that, it is something, it's like birth all over again. Because we've always heard the phrase, express a man to another man, I'm a grown, you know what, man. Don't talk about it. Sometimes you may not know what to do. But there comes a time as we look at our children as they grow up and we find out they've come to a spot that they're adults, but you know what? They truly become a man. It's like being born again. Now, it's not us going back through the flesh and becoming that way. It's us saying, you know what? Only be born for what? Through blood, through Jesus Christ. That's the only way we can be reborn again. And when you see that, it becomes very emotional. And when you feel it, it becomes very emotional. And I would imagine, I'll use this example, when you looked at Jill and he finally became a man, and he just probably got to the point and said, I'm a man, I know what I'm doing. But when he finally became a man, it probably made you emotional. Because you knew he was truly a man. You know, and that's why I saw it with got one, he's waiting to be that way. I got another one, he just turned that way. But these are adults. And as far as parents, when we see that within our children, it makes us feel so good. We become overly emotional about that. Could you imagine what God feels when he sees that we're truly born again, that we're taking that time out saying, you know what, it's you. I'm ready to be born again. And it's not the way that other people think it is to be born again, because they'll think something totally different. It's like that ticket. The world says you got to pay for it, but God says all you have to do is believe. The ticket's there for you to take. You just got to believe. You got to believe, and the other thing you got to do is you got to be on board. Because you can take the ticket, but if you're not on board, it does you no good. Because sometimes we get that way also. We'll take the ticket, but we won't be on board. We say, I believe, but we won't really be on board. So it's actually a very good lesson when we look at it. Sometimes we have to break these things down and look at the word to word to see what they're truly trying to say. Because sometimes we'll just read through it real quick. And I'm just going to go a little bit further into the lesson, if I can. And I'm going to go down to the 13th verse, here if I can. Make sure it's the 13th verse. It says, no one has ever gone into heaven except the man who came from heaven, the Son of Man. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the desert, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. Now that goes back to Moses' time. I'm going to read that real quick. And as I read that, I thought about today's time. And this is in Numbers, 21st chapter, and I'm going to do some reading from the middle of the fourth verse. And this is when the people, they were Israelites, they came out. Moses took them out. And it says this, but the people grew impatient on their way. They spoke against God and against Moses and said, why have you brought us out of Egypt to die in the desert? There is no bread, there is no water. And we detest this miserable food. That's like us right now. Believe it or not. We say the same thing, but in different words. But we're at a point right now, it says, then the Lord sent venomous snakes among them. They bit the people, and many Israelites died. That's kind of like where we're at right now. You know, because we said, you know, why take, you know, you took us out, we had it good. We were enslaved, but we had it good. But you took us out. And the Lord said, you know, it's in these snakes now. Kind of wake them up. This is pretty much what part of the lesson is saying right here. Then Moses came to the people and said, the people came to Moses and said, we sinned when we spoke against the Lord and against you. Pray that the Lord will take the snakes away from us. So Moses prayed for the people. The Lord said to Moses, make a snake and put it up on a pole. Anyone who is bitten can look at it and live. That means we got to have belief. Even though we're surrounded by snakes, we got to have belief. And that's part of being on board. Because we'll take the ticket, but we won't get on board. I just want to read that little part there, as far as talking about the lesson also. Because we have to understand what it takes. Sometimes we'll just read that one little part, and we'll be gone with it. And for the youngsters, this is very important also, because people will beat you up with little bits and pieces of the word, and it's expect you to move on with it. So we have to be very careful. You've heard about these people that said they're going to pick up their snake, and if it don't bite you, it's okay. But it's not about that anymore. Because snakes come in different forms. Believe it or not. And a real snake will bite you. Believe it or not. So for our young people as well as our older people, we have to look at the word, and we have to truly read the word and understand what it's saying. But we just can't take a little piece of it. We've got to take the whole thing. Like Easter dinner. It's coming up. you have just a little piece of it, it may be okay. But if you eat the whole thing, it's so much better. You take the ham, you put it with the mashed potatoes, and everything that comes with that meal, it's a great meal. It's like the word. You take the whole word together, it's a great word. You just can't take a little piece of it. And look at the entire world. And throughout our whole life, we have to look at the entire world. God's saving love in Christ. He didn't come here just for the sake of coming here. And the Bible says he didn't come here to condemn us. But he came here for the purpose of giving us a way of getting up and out. So that we wouldn't be condemned. So I'm going to stop right there with the lesson. There's a lot more that's there. I'm going to ask you to read also. Because it's very important that we look at these lessons and we read. Most important as we read the lessons and we understand what's going on, that we are the ones that stand as a testimony each and every day for what God has done to us. You know, as I say, when I'm out there driving in my car last night, Tony, she didn't notice it. The sisters didn't notice it. But I was nervous and I was sweating. Because I got traffic on one side of me, I got traffic on the other side of me, and I'm trying to figure out what's going on. I got to make sure I get the right connections. But I have to look cool. And I'm holding on to the meal. Well, because I'm holding on, like I'm supposed to hold on with Jesus. Because I know if I let it go, anything can happen. We have to learn how to hold on. Just hold on. Believe, hold on, grab your ticket, and be on board. So I hope you got a little bit off the lesson. I just want to kind of stop right there. Let's say I was going to say something, do something, and I'm going to sit down. And that's going to be it. My wife told me this morning, you don't have to talk all day long. You just have to sit down. That's it. So, with that, I hope you got something off the lesson. As always, thank you.
serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that he's living, whatever men may say. I see his hands of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. And just the time I need him, he's always near. He lives, Christ Jesus lives.
Changed his behavior before that Amalek drove him away as he departed. But David knew how to run back to God. Amen. See, Satan has a strategy, but we have to know God, the Most High God, the possessor of heaven and earth, and a deliverer from all our enemies. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. That song said, oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, oh, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, oh, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. And David said, I sought the Lord, and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him, and they was light, and their face was not ashamed. And I always put my name here. Priscilla cried, and the Lord heard her and saved me out of all my troubles. The angels of the Lord encamped round about them that fear him and deliver them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. Oh, taste. That's just like we, Brother Dick was talking about food. Oh, taste, whether it's good food or bad food. But when you taste the word of God, you get good food. Jesus said, he is the bread of life. The Bible is real clear when we go through this life facing affliction and our circumstances. But that does not mean that because you and I are afflicted, it's because we go through trials, because Jesus said, we're going to have trials, and we're going to have tribulation, but be of good cheer. Jesus have overcome everything that we go through. And because we have burdens, it is proof of God that God will work in all our circumstances.
Amen.
Because he said, I'll never leave you. Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the earth. That means until we again calling to be with the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
The scriptures are not hard to understand when we seek God and when we seek him with our whole heart. God will deliver you and me out of any trial and temptation that we go through. Again, all we have to do is trust and believe. Trust and believe. All things are possible to them, what? To them that believe. Amen. And as God's servant, as his disciple, as his children, we are to do it God's way and not man's way. And I'm urging you this morning not to let the devil use the circumstances of your life to bring doubt, which will result in defeat. I heard Brother White say, I'm not letting the devil. No, the devil is already under your feet. And God is the healer.
Amen.
Of
yes,
every disease. He said, I'm the Lord thy God that healeth all your diseases. He said, I even fill your mouth with good things so that your youth be renewed like an eagle.
Amen.
But you got to seek him. He said, whatever you ask the Father my name, in Jesus' name, that will I do that the Father may be glorified in the Son. God wants to use your circumstance and my circumstances in order for him to get the glory.
Amen.
Many times we think the devil is trying to stop us. The devil want to worry. But the devil going to get zero in trying to do what God have already blessed. When God have blessed you, no man can unbless you. And all you got to do is look and say, I'm blessed and highly favored.
Amen.
I'm blessed going out and I'm blessed coming in.
Yes.
And you speak life into your dead body.
Amen.
Into every circumstance that you come up. I speak life. I declare and decree it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He said, whatever you declare and decree in my name, that will I do.
Amen.
And he's a God that can't lie.
Amen.
And he won't lie. You just got to believe. God can use every circumstance for his glory.
Yes.
He can use your problem, because we do have problems.
Yes.
Because our circumstances, again, I say, is God's opportunity to show himself strong on our behalf.
Yes.
Amen.
Oh, I love it. Because I just watch and see what he's going to do.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
He take care of everything.
Yes.
Amen. And when you go through the valley, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death? I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. The valley of the shadow. You see, just a shadow behind me. You see? And when I walk, I fear no man. I fear nothing but the Almighty God. Amen?
Amen.
Perfect love. When you made perfect love in Christ, and when you love like God has loved, you don't fear anything.
Amen.
Nothing. God will use your circumstances to see if you and I are going to be faithful.
Amen.
Faithful to him and faithful to his word. And sometimes we do get discouraged. Because we're human. We have God's spirit in us. We are the children of God, but we're still human. Sometimes I even look up and say, what did I do? And then he'll give me a song to sing. Then I say, oh, you're still with me.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. God is good.
Yes,
all the time.
Yeah.
I can share this with you. I had a little piece of money in my purse this week. And I said, you know what? Let me go pick up a few things. And I left. Shania and I, and we left out. We could pick it up, go to the store. I got in the store. And after they rang up the merchandise, it looked at me and said, my total came to $79. And it looked at me and said, you have $70 in rewards. I said, really?
Praise God.
Yeah. I said, for real? I said, are you kidding me? And he said, no. No, ma'am. Do you want to use some? I said, I want to use it all.
Amen.
Amen.
And it left me doing $9 and some change. And you know what I did with that bill? I took that bill and I sold it in the work of God. You see? And God will bless. You have to sow in order to reap. I didn't keep it and spend it on for my personal self, but it was to give back to God. Give. And it shall be given. Good measure, pressed down, shaking over, running over, God would have means to give into your bosom. God look after his children. Amen?
Amen.
That's why, you know, it's not so hard to pay your tithe. Give, and once you give your tithe to the Lord, he can rebuke whatever's going on in your life. You can talk to him. Whatever circumstances that you have, you can tell God about it. God, you said you rebuked the devourer for my sake. Whatever's trying to destroy you or your family or your loved one, amen, God will rebuke the devourer for your sake. You got to try. Amen. That's the best loan giver you can give. Amen. That's the best bank you can put your money in.
Amen.
Amen. All right. God will use all our circumstances. He will use it to prove it. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And when we go through trials and battles, we can run for the Lord. Because he said what? The battle is not yours and mine. The battle is his. I told a young lady, God said, be still and see the salvation of God. Yes. And she said, thank you. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
God will let you know that one can put 1,000 devils to flight and two can put 2,000 devils to flight.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Don't you know when we come together and pray, what a wonderful job God would do.
Amen.
Can you see those devils fleeing in the name of Jesus? When we get down before God and we begin to pray and agree with one another, God begins to move on our behalf. Amen?
Amen.
But something, I tell God, something is wrong. You can't make nobody believe. They just want to believe on their own. And what God said, nothing shall come nigh, no pledge shall come nigh thy dwelling. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. God is real.
Mm-hmm.
God is real. God is alive.
Amen.
He was the one that woke us up this morning.
Amen.
He was the one that said, I'm going to let you live another day. I'm going to let you have activity of your limbs.
Yes.
I'm going to let you come into the house. It's no mistake that we are here this morning.
Right.
God said, I'm going to let you go into the house of God, one where it's peaceful and quiet. And you can praise and worship me in the name of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Our circumstances is an opportunity to draw us nearer,
yes,
to God. Have you ever just felt like you're just going on, just moving on and just moving on, and all of a sudden all hell break loose and you run into God? He said, I know how to get you there. I know how to bring you back. Amen? And then when we run into him, then God revealed himself strong on our behalf. Amen?
Amen.
And no circumstances that we go through will ever get easy until we go into God.
Amen.
So you and I got to rest assured of God's deliverance. For that God can use our circumstances as an opportunity to declare his glory. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. We have to depend on the Almighty God. Get with God. Spend time with God. Talk to him just like you're talking to the children or a friend or someone on the telephone. Have a conversation with him. Talk to him. You can tell him your likes. You can tell him your dislike. You can just let it all go out. You don't have to call nobody else on the phone to tell him that. You go to God in prayer.
Yes.
And he hears our prayer.
Yes.
Now I know that he hears me.
Amen.
And he hears me only.
Yes.
Then he said, I cried unto the Lord, and he heard me, and he saved me out of all my trouble. No trouble, no pain, going unnoticed by God. Nothing in our life going unnoticed by our Heavenly Father. God will reveal to you, he will help you, he will show you the way. He will lead you, he will guide us, he speaks to us through his Spirit and the Word. And if you don't know the Word, you can't use the Word. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. You have to know what thus said the Lord. That's so easy. It's real easy. The righteous cry. The righteous cry. And the Lord hears them and delivers them out of all their trouble. The Lord is night unto them that have a broken heart, and save such as be in a contrite spirit. When you have a broken and a contract spirit, God will come to your rescue. He tells us, say, come ye children, hearken unto me, and I will teach you the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord. That's respect and how to honor God. Yes. Amen?
Amen?
We're going to go through something. And it's going to get worse all around us. But we're going to have to pray and trust in God. Amen?
Amen.
God said, I know how to get my children to come back to me and to pray. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Our world is in turmoil. Our leaders need prayer. This is God's world,
amen,
not man's world. And God is saying, I got you now. You will pray.
Amen.
You will call out to me. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And there's a such thing as bind and loosen. Binding and loosen. That's what we have to do. Amen?
Amen.
Use the word.
Yes.
These are spirits that we are dealing with on this earth. They're not the spirit of Christ. It's the spirit of the evil one. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We got to tell the devil to take his hand off of God's property.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And be set free. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Amen. Don't be scared to use the word. Amen. Use God's word. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus died. He said, I've given you power over all power of the enemy.
Yes.
And you can thread on snakes, serpent. He tell you what they are. And nothing by any means should hurt you. Nothing. Don't you know that's power?
Yes.
Don't you know that's power?
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
You can stand before the biggest devil in this world and look him directly in the face and let him know. You ain't got to tell him that you're a child of God because it's already over. God said, everybody will know that you called by the name of the Lord. They're going to be afraid of you. Amen?
Amen?
And all God wants you to do is just love. Love. And love one another. And to love God with your whole heart, mind, body, and soul. Let's give God a hand clap. Let your brother give you a hand clap. Amen. And let's give Deacon Daniel, Deacon Willie, and brother brother Dickie a hand clap. Amen. But I got them for Lord willing, enough to have for next year. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right.